Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX were meant to launch the Starlink 20 mission earlier today, but they have postponed the launch again. They tweeted, now targeting Thursday, March 11th at 3:13 a.m. EST for launch of Starlink, taking some additional time for pre-launch checks. Taking a look at the SpaceX fans website, you can see that we are just days away from another Starlink launch. Starlink 21 is expected to launch on Saturday at 10:06 a.m. UTC or 5:06 a.m. EDT. There's a new article about a recent filing to the FCC with regards to operating Starlink. It says SpaceX has plans to make Starlink service available on the move according to a new Federal Communications Commission filing that was published on March 5th. SpaceX's requests to operate Starlink terminals in moving vehicles, vessels and aircraft. Michael Sheets tweeted about it saying the company submitted an FCC request to begin installing and operating terminals on moving vehicles from cars and trucks to ships and jets. Musk responded with, not connecting Tesla cars to Starlink as our terminal is much too big. This is for aircraft, ships, large trucks and RVs. Tyler Gray tweeted about another contract that has been awarded to SpaceX. He said, Justin, SpaceX and ULA have been awarded launch contracts by the US Air Force as part of the NSSL Phase 2 solicitation. ULA gets USSF 112 and USSF 87 for $224.3 million. SpaceX gets USSF 36 and MROL 69 for $159.7 million. He also added another tweet saying both companies are expected to complete launch services by no earlier than Q4 2023. Let's head to Boca Chica where the Orbital Pad A ground support equipment area construction is progressing. The work on the high bay has been continuing also. Musk was asked, are you guys chilling on top of the high bay which is soon to be a SpaceX bar? He responded with, I was just up there, elevator on the other side, floor is in, glass coming soon. A new thrust simulator has been spotted in the yard with the rams being installed. SpaceX has filed for a new trademark with the Starbase name. Elon Musk recently tweeted creating the city of Starbase, Texas, in which he says he wants Boca Chica to be called Starbase. Raptor SN59 was spotted being delivered to the yard. Austin Bernard posted some cool shots of the SN11 legs being tested recently. Musk gave some information on SN10 saying SN10 engine was low on thrust due to partial helium ingestion from fuel header tank. Impact of 10 meters per second, crushed legs and part of skirt, multiple fixes in work for SN11. Chris B from NSF tweeted about that piece of information that Elon Musk gave. He said this is a tricky one given that I believe said helium pressurization was added to the methane header tank to mitigate what happened with SN8. That's why it's a test program, of course. Musk responded with, fair point, if autogenous pressurization had been used, methane bubbles would most likely have reverted to liquid. Helium in header was used to prevent ullage collapse from slosh which happened in prior flight. My fault for approving, sounded good at the time. Everyday Astronaut also asked Musk, are there baffles in future designs to prevent slosh? Elon Musk responded and said there were baffles but one may have acted like a straw to suck bubbles in from above liquid or gas level. Something similar happened on an early Falcon 1 flight resulting in unexpectedly high liquid oxygen residuals at main engine cutoff. There was another tweet asking has the SpaceX team concluded with a better landing leg design for Starship? Musk responded with might just catch the ship with the launch tower same as booster. Everyday Astronaut asked another question about removing the 30 tons of landing propellant and trying to catch Starship in a huge net. Musk said, yeah, we talked about that internally. Could just have it land on a big net or bouncy castle. Lacks dignity but would work, but optimized landing propellant is only approximately 5% of dry mass, so it's not a game changer. Starship SN11 has been rolled out since the flight of SN10 with the vehicle rolling to the launch site on Monday. Teams then worked to hook it up to the launch mount and are getting everything ready for testing and hopefully a static fire coming up soon. Yesterday, Tankzilla was also detached from the prototype and SN11 did an ambient test. Looking at the Cameron County website, road and beach closures were posted for yesterday, today, tomorrow and Friday 12th. This is likely for some cryo testing as they performed an ambient pressure test yesterday evening. The two-ring stack you can see on the left here is the leg skirt for Starship SN18. Also, as well as all the other prototypes currently under construction, this two-ring stack is the leg skirt and first piece spotted for serial number 20. Last episode we saw a heavy-duty mount moved in the yard, now they are stacking the bottom of super heavy booster number 1 on it. As always, these Boca Chica updates wouldn't be possible without Mary or Boca Chica Girl out there all day every day filming, so thank you. Also, a thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their great videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.